The ProSiebenSat.1 Group is one of the leading media corporations in Europe, with reach to more than 41 million households in Germany, Austria, and Switzerland, along with international production network. Seven Ventures, the venture unit of ProSiebenSat.1 Media, concentrates in digital commerce, media, and broadcast-oriented companies as a core investment target. Please welcome our next speaker, CFO and Managing Director of Seven Ventures Accelerator, Hanno Stegmann.
Hi, everybody. Hi, everybody. Thanks for having me. What I would like to do in the couple of next 10, 15 minutes is to just share my view and our position on, first of all, why is a media company, a TV media company like ProSiebenSat.1 actually investing in digital businesses, and why can TV media make a difference in accelerating digital startups? Just to give you a bit of an overall glimpse of what ProSieben is, ProSieben is basically the biggest private TV network in Germany, around EBITDA of around 800 million euros, a big corporation, but of course, like every TV business, and we need to face the challenges of the new economy, mostly the big question, what's happening when this kind of extremely successful and highly profitable business like TV is coming to a stall and coming to an end? Where are our new opportunities for growth? And most of all, how can we profit with our existing assets when we tap into these new growth opportunities? Because you heard it perhaps from some of my colleagues who had different speeches here before me. As an investor, you always need to answer the questions, why are you smarter than another investor, or what can you bring to the table that others investors cannot bring to the table? And I strongly believe that the synergies that a company like ProSieben, but also other TV and media companies can bring to the table, the synergies of marketing power and of acceleration power, that can be a big differentiating factor when you think about like us as an investors and others. So a big part of the strategy of the group is to leverage that, to tap into digital ventures, and to use the strength that we have in TV to build up great e-commerce ventures. And I make a couple of examples how we are doing that, how we're trying to do that, and where we succeeded already in doing so. I'll skip that. The vision of the group definitely is, as I highlighted, not to leave the broadcasting business behind, but to develop into something that's more than just a TV unit, but a digital entertainment and e-commerce powerhouse that's using all these different elements in a very synergetic and proactive way. You see here on the screen basically the elements that are especially of interest to us, because in the center, of course, there is the millions and millions of viewers we can attract with a typical TV program, and we try to leverage that first, of course, nearly kind of core business for us, to attract them to online video offers. Also, online games is a very key focus for us because it's a very similar user experience as an entertainment element. It's music. I think we also had a lot of talks here yesterday with the founder pitches, also for music-related ventures, and e-commerce, where we can try to split up into niche segments within e-commerce where we have the feeling the synergies are the greatest, and I'll give you a couple of examples where we did that and why we think there are especially synergetic elements for us to invest. But of course, as a corporate investor, you always need to structure yourself in a way that where do we invest, which kind of stages do we invest, which kind of risk are we going to take? And our approach is twofoldish. So we founded, I think, as one of the first media companies in Germany, an own accelerator program. And my colleague Jens is here, He is running this accelerator program and can probably, for everybody of you who is interested in joining a program that, like that, give you a bit more introduction. But it's basically our very small bets to work with very young teams, extremely early stage, kind of seed, idea, prototype stage, and to build up an own venture unit where we invest more into the rounds, CD, or even later majority acquisitions. And that is what Seven Ventures is doing, what I'm doing, to really make bold investments into companies that we can then further push, not only with the cash that we invest, but also with all the other synergies that we can bring to the table and that a group like ProSieben can contribute. So as I said already mentioned, accelerator program, more mentoring stage, very, very early on. I think it's great for a big corporation to get this entrepreneurial spirit in, just to bring in new, fresh thoughts, even though it may not in every case be a great commercial success, but then also have a very separate, very dedicated unit with a venture capitalist kind of approach, which is what we do at Seven Ventures. I think why is, and I will skip that, why is the Seven Ventures approach a bit special, and why am I standing here to tell you about this whole ideas around synergies in media? It's because we not only invest cash, we also invest basically the opportunity of free marketing spots on our TV channel. So we are kind of the inventor of this so-called media for equity model, where we basically tell the companies we work with, you get a specific sum of money, but in addition to that, you get the opportunity to air and to promote your product at our TV channels to a huge audience. You really need reach every German household, and this has a massive marketing value. So we did that with Zalando, for example. You probably read that they went public yesterday. I think the first big e-commerce company in Germany that also did a successful IPO. A lot of other companies, perhaps like Trivago, Lieferheld, Delivery Hero, these kind of companies you know as well. So it's kind of a broad portfolio of companies where we managed through this kind of very unique approach to be part of the investor team, because we could offer something that nobody else could. Just because it's a bit of a special situation in the German media market, there's always something like an unsold TV inventory. So you would not always sell all the free spots, so all the spots you have. There's always kind of a residual of free marketing inventory that you can use in this kind of corporations to the big, big benefit of the portfolio companies we work together with. So we always call it a bit like, the secret, the secret of a partnership with us, that they have this additional boost from the media. So at the moment, 40 equity investments, very broad, very much focused on everything that's B2C, because we can trigger, of course, purchases with the TV media, so B2B is less of interest for us, and quite a wide range of activities with different bets that we made. I just want to tap into a bit more concrete examples how that works. I think that's for you probably ridiculous because it's so much basic. But of course, the question is always, how can you drive your business and how can you drive marketing? So what's the influence on visits, on your conversion rate, on the orders, on your basket size, and on revenues? And I want to show you a couple of examples why a smart mix of performance media and something like TV media, at least for the big scale businesses, can be very, very attractive. Because with the normal performance marketing you're doing, you are, of course, have a full range of activities, the whole affiliate activities, Zemzeo, etc. But what TV can benefit or can bring to the table is you can really establish a brand, which is important for a lot of companies, especially in the e-commerce sector. you can establish a lot of trust, extremely important in a lot of transaction-based companies, and especially in high-value services, that you know this is not a random internet site. It's something I've seen on TV. I trust them. They have a good reputation. And of course, you can also create a very immediate call to action. We have a lot of measurements where you can very nicely see that a lot of people are having their tablet on the couch when they are watching TV. They're actually not watching less TV. It's actually increasing in all of the nations, the number of minutes watched. But this parallel usage of having a second device, a second screen, how we call it, next to you, is also increasing dramatically. So the immediate reaction from seeing a spot to visit the website and then to shop is very, very imminent. One nice example you could definitely see, and that's how we work with our portfolio companies, is to measure, you know, what was your baseline of traffic before we started the campaign, and how has it been developed when we air the first campaigns and we air the first flight. But not only that, it's very much of an analysis, not only purely like just a simple traffic analysis, but analysis of all the different channels and all the different levers of your, in this case, e-commerce models. Because first big question is, what's the influence on the conversion rate? We normally observed, because of this trust-building element, that conversion rates are actually increasing. You see that even basket sizes, you know, they are varying, of course. People tend to shop more, perhaps for a little, like smaller basket sizes, but it has not a big negative effect on basket sizes as well. You see that even after the campaign, because of the brand building effect, the trust effect, you have like a very different, traffic baseline even after the campaign, and of course all your other channels, like your other marketing costs, are also positively affected, because you typically get a lot of more, much more direct traffic, direct search. You can bid for cheaper keywords because the consumer has already heard about your brand, has kind of, you know, been impacted by your brand much more intensively through this kind of a campaign. And I'm happy to chat about this analytics with you later and after the talk. I mean, just because of the Zalando IPO, you know, when I talk about shoes and say it's an example, you can probably guess what kind of company that may be. You can definitely see that also a huge campaign can create also a completely new market. And that's something what we observed in Germany when we were one of the first partners of Zalando, that just the whole category to shop shoes online completely changed after this campaign and after this boost we did together. It was a completely different business, and it was so much into the mind of consumers that this is something that you can shop online, which they never actually did before. I will not bore you because I see my clock here ticking with more statistics, but I'm happy to tell around it anytime. So my key messages for you are the following. First of all, of course, TV converts, you know, your potential target group into customers. It creates a lot of trust. It can create brands, which is especially in e-commerce and transaction different models, driven models, like a huge asset for you. It therefore creates a lot of value. So we have also observed in our exits, we did a huge impact on valuation of, you know, companies that have already managed to establish a brand with a loyal consumer base. But last but not least, it can also create a market. So if you watch out also for competitors that are doing a campaign in specific segments, also you can probably with your business profit a lot from that, because big campaigns can really change whole market dynamics. You know, with that I leave you, but I promise my colleagues also, if you're interested in, you know, in any ways to work together with 7Ventures or with also our accelerator program, because I know there are a lot of startups here, just approach me or my colleagues. And probably Plamen will kill me for that, but we are also active at the NOAA conference, and we do a pitch session there. And you know, perhaps next time we do it at the WebIt, but this time is still NOAA. So if you're interested in that, applications are still open for our pitch session at NOAA in London, November, and you're invited to apply. Happy, you know, that you spent the time with me here, and thank you very much.